Today we're going to talk about the BlinkM. It's a I2C LED. So first I want to explain I2C. I2C is integrated circuit. So it's abbreviated I2C for most people. And on the RAMPS board, we have four I2C pins right here. Now the first pin is our voltage pin, which is 5 volts. Our next pin is ground. Then our next pin, which is pin 20, is our serial data pin. And then we have our serial clock pin right here. So in a moment, I'll show you a close-up of the BlinkM, so you have a better idea of what the pins are. Okay, underneath here you can see the pins. We have our negative pin right here. We have our positive pin right here, which is the voltage pin. This is ground. Then we have our pin that's labeled as D, which stands for serial data, so SDA. Then we have our C, which is serial clock. So that's known as SCL. So in a moment, I'll show you how to connect it to the RAMPS board. Okay, in order to connect it, what we're gonna do is we're gonna connect the red jumper to our positive pin that's labeled on here. Then we're gonna connect our black jumper to the ground pin. Then we're gonna connect for our data, the brown jumper. And then finally, for the clock, we're gonna connect the white jumper. So in a second, I'll show you how to connect that to the RAMPS board. Okay, now to connect it to the RAMPS board, first we're gonna start with the voltage pin, which is the furthest one over. Then we're gonna do the black wire, which is ground. Next, we're going to do the serial data, which is our brown wire. And finally, we're gonna connect the clock pin. So in a moment, I'll show you how to connect the USB so we can program it with the Marlin firmware. Okay, in order to connect it, we need to use the USB. So we're gonna connect the big side to the RAMPS Arduino board. Then we're gonna connect the small side to the computer and you're gonna hear a beep. Now keep in mind the LED will illuminate until after we've set up the firmware and begin our test. So keep your hands away from any of this area because it's unsafe to touch. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, we want to open up the Marlin folder for Marlin 1.1.9. Then the Marlin subfolder. Then we want to press M on the keyboard and scroll down to marlin.ino and press enter. Okay, now that we're in the Marlin folder, we're going to click on the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on motherboard. And it looks like we have the correct motherboard for board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. So we're going to search on BlinkM. And we're going to uncomment define BlinkM. Next, we're going to go over to the ports and make sure that we have a port selected, which we do. And then our board is selected, which is the Arduino Mega 2560. So in a moment, we're going to compile and upload, but I want to remind you that the I2C connection can also be used for LCD panels and other devices. So in a moment, I'll show you how to test the BlinkM after we compile and upload with the upload button. Okay, we're in the Pronterface folder. So we're going to open up Pronterface.exe. And what we're going to do is the first thing we're going to do is connect to the 3D printer board for the RAMPS. Next, we're going to type the command M150R0U0. Remember, there's a space in between. And B0. And what I'm going to show you in a moment is I'm going to press enter. And the flashing light that we saw when we connected the USB will change. So here we go. So what we discovered is by entering zeros for each value, we've turned off the light. So let's change R0 to 255 and press enter and see what happens. And as you can tell, the light has changed from nothing to red. Now let's try doing B0 to 255 and pressing enter and seeing what happens with R255 as well. So now it's turned violet. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.